Hi everyone, welcome back to VSDC channel. If you've ever shot a video that ended up a little too shaky, then you're in the right place. In today's tutorial, we're going to walk you through the process of smoothing out all those unwanted camera shakes using VSDC and show you how to tweak the settings to get the perfect balance for your video. Now, let's jump right in. First, launch the program and navigate to the Tools tab on the ribbon command bar. Then select Video Stabilization. This will bring up the stabilization window. Go ahead and maximize it to fill your screen for a better view. Now it's time to bring in the video you wish to stabilize. Simply drag and drop the shaky footage right into the workspace. The stabilization tool comes with an array of parameters, and we have a detailed article on our website for those who want to dive deeper into these settings. Feel free to check it out. You'll find the link in the video description below. Today we are going to show you two presets, one to remove shakiness to create a static frame and another one to smooth out the camera movement. Don't hesitate to pause the video and try out each step as we go. For our first example, we want to eliminate the shake and make a static camera, something that is common in handheld footage. Let's walk through the settings that we've picked to solve this issue. The first parameter is shakiness. We'll set it to 10 for maximum stabilization. The higher the value, the stronger the stabilization effect will be. Next up is accuracy. We'll crank this up to the max, which is 15, to ensure that we're detecting as much of the shake as possible. Then we have the step size parameter, affecting the quality of the video. Let's set this to the minimum of 1 to keep it high. If your computer is rather slow, do not set up all these parameters to the maximum to speed up the stabilization process, but be aware that it may reduce precision. Now let's see what we can do with the calculated camera shake applying the next group of the parameters. The smoothing parameter determines how much you can smooth the movement. We want the camera to be static and set 0 since smoothing results in additional camera movement within the frame. If the value is different from 0, the camera will move smoothly. Next, for maximum shift and maximum angle, we're setting both to -1, indicating no limits on the stabilizer's zooming and rotation. As for the contrast threshold, let's set it to 0.25. If your footage is less contrasty, you might go lower, but this could significantly increase the stabilization time. For the highest quality, you can set it to 0. The next parameter, zoom, is set to 1, which means that the image will be enlarged by 1% during stabilization. Then we set the zoom speed parameter to 0 and use a static zoom with a value of 1%. After that, we disable smoothing and select bicubic interpolation to make the edges of the object smooth. In the camera settings, we will pick Gaussian for sharp jerks, and if the footage is smooth, optimal would be a better choice. The final parameter is crop, and we'll leave the remaining parameters at their default settings. All that is left to do now is to set the export settings. We'll select the resolution and set the quality to 100%. If the footage is still a bit shaky, you can adjust the contrast threshold parameter to 0 for even more stabilization. Now you can see the result before and after the stabilization, and it looks great. The settings for the stabilizer are up on the screen for you to check out. Alright, let's move on to another preset where the camera is in motion, and we want to smooth out that movement. As before, let's upload our video into the stabilizer window. In this case, the camera is moving, and our goal is to make this movement more fluid. We head into the settings and increase the smoothness parameter to 15, considering 15 frames before and after each frame for smoothing. We will also set the contrast threshold parameter to 0 for utmost precision, and keep zoom at 1%. Since the camera is moving, we will choose adaptive zoom and add some smoothing. camera settings will be on optimal, with the other settings as in the previous preset. And then we will review the outcome. Now, let's output the result and take a look. You see, the movement has become much smoother, and the stabilizer has done a fantastic job. On the screen right now, you can see the settings that we used for the stabilizer. To wrap up, we will quickly review the stabilizer settings again. To avoid overwhelming you with technical terms, we have created a color-coded scheme for the groups of parameters. Green highlights on the screen are quality-related settings that might increase analysis time. Blue indicates the strength of the stabilization effect. Yellow narrows the range for stabilization actions. Red controls motion smoothing. Orange is for zoom usage. Purple changes the analysis algorithm. And white trims the black borders resulting from zoom and rotation. Finally, the light blue parameter creates various effects. For instance, reversing the direction of the effect can amplify the shake. Or using absolute instead of relative coordinates can also increase shaking. And that's all for today's tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials. And see you next time!